In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved one, today is 22nd November, and being the feast of the solemnity of Christ, the King of the universe, and the 31st Sunday being the last Sunday in the year A of the church calendar. Our readings will be coming from Prophet Ezekiel chapter 34, verse 11 to 12, and verse 15 to 17. Our responsorial psalm will come from Psalm 23, verse 1. Our second reading will be coming from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20 to 26 and 28. Our gospel message will come from Matthew Gospel chapter 25, verse 31 to 46. The theme of our message today is Christ is the King of the universe. And if Christ is the King of the universe, the King has the power to make laws, has power to enforce laws, a power to judge the three arms of government. He's the judge, he's the lawmaker, he's the chief executive. So Christ has to be all this to be our King. And his own kingship is a king who sets a model for other people to take step with. But it's unfortunate we're not doing his own step, but they have set out a model for all of us to follow. Christ is the King of the universe. In the first reading, he made us to know that he's the good shepherd. And the good shepherd is the one who cares for the sheep. And that's why he said, we seek out his sheep. Wherever they were scattered, he will gather them back. And when he gathered them back, he will care for them. He will care for the weak, care for the fat, care for the strong. He's not telling you the responsibility of a man who's supposed to lead others. He cares for them. The one that has strayed away, he will bring them back wherever they were. He will be the shepherd of his own sheep. Or the one who started in the day of the crowd and in the day of darkness, he will bring all of them back. So he's telling you the responsibility of a king over his own flock. And that's why he's using this shepherd thing to tell us the responsibility of a king over his own subjects. He thinks for them. He cares for them. He instructs them. He protects them. We are told in the first Corinthians that Christ had been raised from the dead to be the first fruit from those who died. And by one man death came, so by one man comes also the resurrection of the dead. So a bad king brings death, a good king brings life. A bad king brings underdevelopment, a good king brings development to his people. So as death came through Adam, all will come to life in Christ. When all things are subjected to him, himself in turn will subject himself and everything to the Father, who gave him authority over everything. So that God will be everything for everybody at anywhere. So we must be subjected to the God in everything. And these days, most of our present and kings and never wanted, but they just want people, you must obey them, but they don't care for you. It's a one channel. Every person must obey him, but his responsibility, he doesn't care. And they forgot it, that it's your duty, it's your responsibility that earns you your respect. It is your duty that earns you your right. So, when you have offered your duty, you are entitled to a right. But when you talk about your right, but you don't talk about your duty, you become an irresponsible person. You know what the people should do, but you don't know what you will do yourself for them. But you want them to be under you. That's the type of experience we're having these days in the world. People who are there to exploit the people under them, not to help them. Not to promote them, but to destroy them. So, it's the man who is in authority that makes the rules that guide everyone. In the gospel message, we see Christ as a judge. What, how we judge the people who are under his subjects. How to know who are his own and who are not his own. Has given a rule every person must follow. He will put the sheep on his right hand and put goat on his left hand. And we tell the people on his right hand, say, look, come you beloved of my father. Come to the inheritance I was given to you before the foundation of the world. Come to the inheritance. So the reward is already there. It's a question of you to assess it. So the judgment is already fixed. It's for you to tune into it. He will separate the sheep from the lone, and the people on the right hand will say, come, O blessed of my father, come and inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. And the people will say, oh, how do we merit this? He said, yes, you merited this. I was hungry, you gave me food. I was thirsty, you gave me drink. I was a stranger, you welcomed me. I was sick, you visited me. I was in prison, you cared and visited me. I was naked, you clothed me. And people will say, Lord, when did we see you hungry and gave you food? When did we see you thirsty and gave you drink? When did we see you ever as a stranger and welcomed you? When did we see you naked and clothed you? When did we see you sick and came to care for you? When did we see you in prison and came to visit you? Say yes. If you have done it for the least of my brethren, you did it for me. So this is what the message is giving us today as the king of the universe. And the judgment will be based that he created everything on earth for the good of others and for the glory of God. Nothing short of that. And now why the psalmist who understood this so well, the Lord is my shepherd. There's nothing I shall want. I've already made my king. I don't lack anything. So, as we celebrate Christ the King today as the King of the universe, he's the King of everyone and every person subjected to him. And all of us must account before him what we did with all the gifts he has offered, given us. How we live our life for the glory of God and for the good of others. Anything short of that, you'll be damned. But you have done it for others. You are sure of inheriting the kingdom. And we ask God to give us the grace to understand that Christ is the King of kings and the King of the universe. And we're his subjects. And he will judge us in the last day. He will care for us. He will provide for us in everything. But he will judge us equally on the last day. May we come to understand this through Christ our Lord. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us. I will celebrate our Lord and King of the universe. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.